4 or 5 years ago, when these kids were young, I took 17 of them to go to Japan. I spent some money for these kids. Because Uncle Swan didn't know how to invest. Now they all work for us. You know, we have 10 brothers and sisters, and one passed when we were young, so we have 9 left, and the war come, and everything happened, and we get them. My older brother separated in the north, the rest of them in the south. We struggle over the years through the war and go through incredible challenge. And then my father, the died shortly after that when I was 15 years old. And I'm the only one in family in Vietnam that I can finish college. And the rest of my brothers and sister never be able to finish college. Some of them have some high school. And I also the luckiest one who was able to escape to this country in 1975. The rest of them stuck there. So, you know, it's circumstance drive you, you know, you're forced to think about family, you have to do things, because you have to step up, you have to do something, and that's part of my life, and then, you know, it's just like, well, sometimes I just felt like, why is me, you know, why I'm the only guy who escaped the U.S., why nobody escaped it together with me, why the burdens are not me. And then my brothers and sisters eventually come to the U.S., and thanks to the generosity of this country, through the reunification program, and through the chance that because my old brother was military and they fight for the war with American, and you know, they took them in. But most of them didn't have a very good job in the U.S. They all making a living. I worry about their future because they don't have no saving. And then they also, you know, pass away. And this is my niece and nephew, and, you know, a lot of time I don't know what to do. I mean, you know, I'm busy to do the business. And one day I just realized that, you know, they're growing up, and what you're going to do to help them, you know. I'm going out every day, and then I'm helping other family. What about these kids? So I could have given them some money, but then I decided to stretch the vision. I believe in the travel. I think vision is the biggest gift that you can give to a human being. So, so I took these kids together with my children. I mean, I just want to tell you that I don't wish Alicia, but she know what I feel. And Alicia is also a family person. Since she was young until now, it's always, she makes sure at least once a month or more, she's gonna go out with her cousin and spend time with her. And she also makes sure that she's not the fortunate kid and the other cousin not fortunate. She won always. That's why since she was young. I mean, it's not that I teach her, but I think probably kid very intelligent. They watch us, so, you know. And you know, they've been pretty close. I have a cousin, a family, and my younger brother passed away, and I worry about this kid, and but I'm pretty happy now. I think that when the kid begin to have a vision and now they have a passion, they'll grow up to be a fine young man and woman. Well, I know that I go to this business a long time before, and I always in the money business, and there's a lot of money around. I always concern one thing is that a good business or bad business. In life, everything you look at, it can be two ways, you know. Whether you're in the medical field to food or any kind of industry, and you can do things good or you can do things bad. You can do things very moral or you can do immoral. You can do things great for people and sometimes you don't do that great. And you know, I just felt like because of the fortunate situation I have, about family, you know, I was saying to you yesterday, I don't know, a lot of times people say that they do this business, they have family conflict. I thought that this business is the best thing to be a family. But people come say that I have a spouse problem. How can you have a spouse problem? You know, to me, when I go out in the field, I think about my wife and my kid more than I stay around them. And my kid and my wife also think about me when I'm away. So we come together. You know, sometimes you're away, but then you're very close. Or sometimes people are very close, but they're not that close. And it's about how your heart feels. And we was able to build a business that the way we wanted, the way we designed. We do not let other people dictate us. We try not to let money change us. We try not to let our ego affect us. You know, when I'm in this business, they always tell me about God first and family second and business third. You know, people say what they do is very different. Sometimes I don't know whether they mean what they say, or is that they say that to sell God to make money. But I think that our business here, it gotta be first the individual, and then your family.